Yeah, that's what you tie off with. Yeah, you can keep that in there. We'll pull it back if we got enough rope. Send him a Facebook in the morning. Uh-huh. Just don't tell him. Tomorrow morning or whenever you do this, the beavers will slap their tail.
Really?
And it's going to sound like a dinosaur's coming up out of that water. And they're just doing it to try and kind of alarm the other beavers. You know, that's their way of, like a deer snorting.
Right.
But it will scare the heck out of you. We won't tell him.
Hey, I think we got plenty of rope.
Coming up on 2 minutes, 15 seconds.
He got me treed up. Yeah. He'd have been like, fuck it, I'm getting
it. He still has Fowl's ball.
What's that?
He still has his
ball. Left his ball.
Hold it up. Hold it up, show the camera.
John's bow.
Left it there.
Nobody can really get into that tree. And way back in here, that's like a choke.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, give it to me. Hold this kind of tight. I'll get your stuff set for now.
Now AJ's going to go for it.
Made it.
Hey everybody, good evening. It's about 3:30. We're first night here in Kansas. Got John Pfeil behind the camera. I'm up to bat tonight. We're in this stand. We call, well, our guide calls, Jason Michael, calls it Three Trees. Really nice stand set up. Deer really can't see you. Pretty high up. We've got a nice river behind us, so real nice stand set up. It's about 60 degrees, got a northeast wind, so we're gonna see what happens. Sit the night out, sit till dark, get out a little bit right before dark so we can cross the river, and then go back to the hotel, and we'll be back at it tomorrow morning. So hopefully tonight's my night, and stay tuned and see what happens.
It's Tuesday, November 19th. It's about 9:15 a.m. Been in the stand since daybreak. About 7:15, or about sitting for about 15 minutes. We had an 8-point or better come in behind us here. Came in and picked up movement or something, busted us, and he took off away from our direction. And about a half hour later, we had either a doe or another small buck coming in behind us on the same trail, but he never came down. Stayed up high. Never knew we were here. And about a half hour ago, I just had a real big buck come in to my left. It's looked like a really, really good A-pointer. He came in and stopped behind a tree, and I got up, got ready, and he just turned and walked away. Went back into where he came from. Something wasn't right. He didn't like what was going on, but you know, the wind's right in our face. He was directly downwind, so stick with us and see what we can get the rest of the afternoon.
Thank you. too long ago. It's about 20 after 3. Same evening spot that me and pro staffer John Pfeil sat in last night. We didn't see any deer. There's a little bit of sign, but I just kind of have a feeling about this stand. I'm by myself, self-filming myself. Everybody else is out on their own. Pro staffer John Pfeil, he went out by himself. He went for a walk. It's pretty windy. This tree is going absolutely crazy. So, also, our friend Troy Medash that came with us, he's sitting in a blind tonight, looking over some pines and some cedars and stuff. He said there's some turkeys close to his blind, but there's a, you know, a lot of good sign over by him, and pro staffer John Pfeil texted me as well and said that there's a lot of good sign over by him, a lot of nice rubs and stuff, so I'm going to sit the night out and hopefully we can get it done. We had a great morning, me and Pfeil. We had a real nice morning in the stand, seeing a lot of great deer. Just couldn't get on him, so stay tuned, everybody. Wednesday, November 20th. It's just about 8 o'clock. We had that little button buck come in not too long ago, probably about 7:45, around there. After he walked away, I heard some rustle out to my left, and I looked up, and there was a nice buck, looked like an 8. He ran up right to the left, and I thought he was just going to keep going straight while I grunted at him a little bit. Threw out a snort wheeze. I couldn't get it on camera. He was just too thick. I couldn't even get the camera around the tree. When I grunted and snort wheezed, I thought he went up the mountain anyways, this thing, however. He actually came right across the ridge. And he stood there probably about 25 yards, but there's no shot there. There's no clearing lane. And he looked. He was looking around and didn't see nothing. Well, then he ran back up. That button buck came up then and went to that buck. I grunted and snort-wheezed again. See if I could get them to come down over here. Then a little three-pointer came on. So all this happened in like a matter of like 2 minutes. I couldn't even get it on camera. It was just so hectic. So far, it's been a good see anything yet, so it's pretty windy out here. About 50 mile an hour wind gusts here in Kansas today, so they're calling for some pretty crappy weather tomorrow, like rain all day and rain later tonight. So I don't know, we're gonna have to see what happens, so just stay tuned, everybody. Hopefully we can get something done before this crappy weather comes in. I'm really hoping.
Alright guys, I shot an 8-point. Jason's coming in now, my guy, to pick me up. Went back, looked at the film, looked like the shot was front. Didn't have full penetration or pass-through, so we'll see. I'm gonna check for some blood and see if you can find the arrow. Buck ran out through the field and cut back down into the woods. I got does out in the field now. Yeah, there's a bunch of deer out. Still out here with me, so. We got two more back here, and he's coming down now, so just about to shoot a doe. There's another deer coming out there, so I was just about to shoot, and I heard some grunting, and I just seen horns coming, and doe moving, so stick with us, we'll see what happens.
Pro-Staff A.J John Pfeil shot a nice buck, but it was a pretty bad shot on the deer. Don't think that the deer, you know, died. So looked over the footage, really wasn't a good shot. The Luminox showed it wasn't really a good shot. So our guy Jason Michael that we're here with, he said the arrow didn't go even in, you know, 4 inches. So we think that we hit that growth plate right there behind the shoulder. So hopefully we could, you know, get a deer down tonight. You know, at least he had an encounter. I had a close encounter last night with a doe after shooting light, but I just couldn't make the shot. So I'm sitting in a new stand tonight in this big cedar tree, covered really well. So hopefully we can get it done tonight. So stay tuned, everyone.
All right, tonight we had a couple deer come in. Couple doe. Movement was slow early. The wind really picked up, and we didn't really think we were going to see much deer movement here on day four. But luckily enough, she came through around 5:15. Made a good shot on her. A little bit far back, but she didn't run any more than 25 yards and keeled over. And we let her lay for a little bit. Now we came back in the dark and got her. So here on day four, we finally got one on the ground. Stay tuned.
22nd. It's about 7:30 in the morning. We're in Montgomery County, Kansas this morning. Hunting the same stand that I sat in on Wednesday morning. Seen that button buck and that real nice buck and that little 3-point. Same stand that John Pfeil seen. That real big buck to his left. I never seen it because I was turned the other way on the cameraman stand, so. But we got a really, really cold morning here in Kansas. It's about 28 degrees. But there's about 90 mile an hour winds that makes it feel like 23 degrees. So it is really, really cold, so. We're gonna sit the morning out a little bit, go back to the hotel, and hopefully we can get it done this morning. If not, I'm gonna try and hopefully get it done tonight. Troy Medash is on the board. What a good doe kill, real big doe. So stay tuned. Keep watching Sugarloaf Mountain Outdoors. Hey everybody, it's about 10 o'clock, we're going to get ready to jump out of the stand a little bit soon. Pro-Staffer John Pfeil's sitting at the top of the ridge here. We got to walk up this one ridge, it kind of goes up on an angle. He's sitting at the top there, so maybe we could push something up to him when we're walking out. After that, I had that doe walk through earlier this morning, another doe came through her same path. And that was it for a little bit. It was pretty quiet, you know. And then about, probably about 9 o'clock to 9:15, I had a little buck behind me. I looked like a 6 or a 7. Probably would have scored about 100 to 110, give or take. He, didn't notice I was there. I grabbed the bow. I turned around. Didn't see me. There's a little barbed wire fence underneath me, and he was trying to jump it. He didn't want to jump it, so he went up a little bit. I see him, and he crawled underneath it. But at least we seen deer this morning for how cold it was. I mean, we didn't come out here for nothing, so. Well, we're going to start packing up soon and, you know, drop the bow down and get out of the stand, and we'll see what happens. So stay tuned. Hey, guys. It's Friday. November 22nd, it's 3:41 p.m., last evening in Kansas. It has just been an awesome, awesome week, even though, you know, nothing special happened yet. I mean, Troy shot a nice doe yesterday, Pfeil shot him at a buck on Wednesday night, out of this stand I'm in tonight. This stand has a lot of potential, so. Hopefully we can get this done today. I'm really looking forward to it, so. Just want to send out a big thank you to Jason Michael for, you know, having us out here and having all these stands set up and all this scouting done and everything. We've seen some real nice deer. I've seen some real big deer. And I just can't wait to come back next year. I'm really looking forward to it, so. We're going to sit tight. We're going to shut the cameras off and got everything set up, so. Hopefully we could come through for you guys tonight, so just got to stay tuned and just want to thank all you guys, all the fans, you know, thank you. We wouldn't be able to do this without, you know, our fans, our friends, our family, so big thank you out to all them and especially the fans, so thanks and just keep on watching Sugarloaf Mountain Outdoors.
Tonight we had kind of a slow evening, but around 5 o'clock I had this one come in. He's kind of moseying through. He's an 8-pointer, 2.5-year-old. It's on our last day, last minute in Kansas here in Montgomery County. Made a good shot on him right behind the shoulder. Looks like I double lunged him. And he ran a decent amount. I heard some crashing, and I bet you he made it probably about 200 yards. And here he is.
Good job, Troy.